And the same could be said of the group of pieces we'll hear next, the four impromptus by Chopin, works which by their very title conjure up the element of spontaneity and elegance. This group includes the Fantaisie-impromptu, the earliest composition of this type, but it was never published in Chopin's lifetime. It contains two elements which made Chopin so popular in the Parisian salons, romantic storm-tossed outer sections, and in the middle, one of his noble, stirring melodies. The other three impromptus also have that air of carefree improvisation. Schumann thought that the first was unique amongst Chopin's compositions, saying it was so refined with its singing melody and charming figuration that he couldn't place it beside any of his other works. The second is remarkable for its variety of moods, including what sounds like a march in the middle. And the third is still elegant but more restrained and more subjective. So here is Grigory Sokolov to perform the four impromptus by Chopin.
Thank you. Thank you.
Grigory Sokolov at the 2005 Schwetzingen Festival playing Chopin, ending that group of Chopin impromptus with the impromptu in G-flat. Well, like so many Russian prize winners, Sokolov has fingers of enormous speed and power, but he also performs with real poetic sensitivity, and that's certainly the case in the final Chopin work we'll hear, the Polonaise-fantaisie, one of the boldest and most complex works which Chopin wrote towards the end of his life, rich in ideas and colours.
Thank you.
The Polonaise-fantaisie in A-flat by Chopin. The pianist receiving the applause for that performance at the Schwetzingen Festival was Grigory Sokolov.